Buenas, Fibe.
Buenas, Fibe. Aleluya.
Aleluya.
Hasta mimi na ushuhuda. Nilikuwa na vaa. Bwana asifiwe. Nilikuwa na vaa size 28. Nina vaa size 34. Siwa ni mzuri. Hiyo niliongeza inchi sita. So in tango. Tangazo la kwanza. Tutakuwa na ibada ya 3 o'clock. Due to the ongoings. Nasikia siasa bado inaendelea. So nataka watu waende kwa nyumba mapema. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Wala napita njia ya kwenda pande huu wapite mapema. Njia ya kwenda naitwaje? Ya Karanda hizo njia. Na basi lejini yetu inapitia katika karibu na hapo. So nataka waende mapema. Wakae kwa nyumba. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
We thank God for what he is doing. I want to believe that sote tuko na afya. Si nashukuru Mungu kwamba sote tuna afya. Na mimi na afya. Mungu ni mwema. Now, nilikuwa naomba sana mwaka mzima kwa tangu Januari. Natoa ushuhuda sasa. Nilikuwa naomba sana pale na nafundisha, nilikuwa naomba Mungu. Mungu. Because when they took up the class 8 in that school, wale walifikiria, unajua mahali mnafanya kazi kuna wale wanajisikia isipokuwa ni wao. Kuna mtu mwingine anaweza kufanya kitu. And then tuombe Mungu. Najua watu wanaojivunia kabila wanajivunia mchafuko. Because kusoma maandiko unakuta pale at the Tower of Babel, what did God do? He confused the language. So hizi language tunazungumza. Wengine wanaongea Kiluya, wengine Kidoluo, wengine Kikuyu, wengine Kikamba. It's a confusion. God confused. So unaporinga sisi, unaringia confusion. You know, it is a type of a curse that God cast on people because they were going against his intentions. So kuna watu ambao usikia kwamba sisi wa kutoka mahali fulani sisi ndio tunaweza. Kutoka mahali fulani hawawezi kitu. So when we took, so happened that we took that classes. Watu wanaotoka sehemu moja. So ikasemekana hawa hawataweza. So whoever was our boss in that area, nikafikiria kugiva, nikamwambia take heart, we are going to do greater than what they have ever done. So we went the whole year. I was just praying, God, let my words come true. I said we shall do better. Lord, let my words come true. And for sure my words came true. And we did better than they have ever done in the last 10 years. Bwana asifiwe.
Yeah.
I was very happy. I was very happy because the last 10 years they have never done that. So those who are despising, I looked direct into their eyes. Nikauliza mnasikiaje? Nikawa tumefurahi kabisa. I didn't want to demoralize them, but I was very happy because God had brought our words to fulfillment. Bwana asifiwe. And even them, they were there rejoicing, celebrating. We have done. Can you imagine? Mmoja alikwambia utaweza, lakini wakati umeweza, na anaanza kusema, tumeweza. Bwana asifiwe. So that's a testimony. I am thanking God because he did what people never expected. Bwana asifiwe. Bwana apewe sifa. So we are very happy. I'm very thankful to God. Bwana asifiwe. I just want to share with us a short sermon, or rather a lesson I'm teaching today. Then we shall call it a day. Bwana asifiwe. I want each one of us to grow a child of God who can stand the test of time. Test of time. And we want to change destinies. Bwana asifiwe. For those of you who are younger than me, I want to tell you, take up these things we teach and change destinies, because you still have a long time to live than myself. Bwana asifiwe. I'm talking those who are younger than I to take this lesson seriously and act on them, because I want you to become a man or a woman who will change destinies. Bwana asifiwe. Somebody wrote a book, Changing Destinies Through Prayer and Fasting. Changing Destinies Through Prayer and Fasting. And this man was a good intercessor. Alikuwa anafunga na kuomba frequently. And for sure, destinies were changed. We can also do the same. We can also change destinies. You can change your own destiny. You can change other people's destinies by prayer and fasting. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
So today I want to talk about praying through. Praying through. We are praying through. So we want to pray through. And what we mean by praying through is that you are not taking no for an answer. You are not taking no from God for an answer. We are going to see Jesus himself encouraging his followers to pray through. We shall also see a woman who never took no from Jesus as an answer. She insisted until Jesus did what she was asking. That is breakthrough. Bwana asifiwe. Bwana apewe sifa. Tell your neighbor, praying through. Would you like to know it?
Yes.
We need to pray through. We need to pray until something happens. That is push. Sindio? Bwana asifiwe. Are you with me really?
Yes.
Push. Push, we say push. Push is pray until something happens. So we don't just pray. But we pray until something happens. I'm encouraging those who are praying in this church never to give up, never to surrender until your requests are granted. Bwana asifiwe. We can pray even for 60 years. We can pray for 70 years. We will pray until something happens. We have to push. And that is what we call praying through. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
So breakthrough is praying until something happens. You are not taking no for an answer. Hata Mungu akisema no, you are still insisting. Lord, I need it. I need it. But you should make sure that you pray according to the will of the Father. Because if you pray against the will of God, I tell you, those things you may be given, which you pray against the will of God, you may be given and they will destroy you. I think I taught that thing here last time, sometime. It will destroy you. It may be given to you, but it may destroy you. So we are asking for things that will bless us, that will benefit us, that will benefit us and our children and our children's children. Wapate faida toka kwa yale tunaomba tukapokea kwa Mungu. So we don't want to get a curse or a punishment from God because of asking for things that God is not willing to give us. But if we pray according to the will of God, then we receive. Bwana asifiwe. The Bible is full of promises. It is full of promises. There are promises of prosperity. There are promises of success. Promises of establishment. Promises of good health. They are there. We need to claim the promises of God to our life. And not ask for things that God never promised us. Because if those are given to us, we are going to suffer. Because we ask against the will of God. Bwana asifiwe. Bwana asifiwe. So, we are encouraged to read the word of God. To read the Bible. Read it honestly. Meditatively. Read that word. And as you read it, you appropriate. Unachukua zile ahadi ambazo Mungu ametoa katika lile neno. Unaziclaim kwa maisha yako. You claim those blessings. Because that is a promise God has given to us as children of God. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
So that is now praying according to the will of God. So we pray appropriating the promises of God unto our lives. And you claim the blessing until it materializes in your life. And you are not willing to give up. You are not willing to surrender until what you are asking is done. That is breakthrough. Bwana asifiwe. The book of Luke chapter 11. The book of Luke chapter 11. We want to read there. Chapter 11 verse 5 to 8. Jesus talks about a friend who comes in the midnight asking for your help. Verse 5 to 8 in a sermon. And he said to them, which of you shall have a friend and go to him at midnight and say to him, friend, lend me 3 loaves. For a friend of mine has come to me on his journey, and I have nothing to set before him. And he will answer from within and say, do not trouble me. The door is now shut, and my children are with me in bed. I cannot rise and give to you. I say to you, though he will not rise and give to him because he is a friend, yet because of his persistence, he will rise and give him as many as he needs. Let's go to verse 9. So I say to you, ask and it will be given to you, seek and you will find, knock and it will be opened to you. For everyone who asks receives, and he who seeks finds, and him who knocks it will be opened. If a son asks for bread from my father, from any father among you, will he give him a stone? Or if he asks for a fish, will he give him a serpent instead of a fish? Or if he asks for an egg, will he offer him a scorpion? If then you be evil, know how to give good gifts to your children, how much more will your heavenly Father give the Holy Spirit to those who ask? So that's Jesus speaking. He gives a parable of this man who has been visited by a friend on a journey, and he has no food in the house. He goes to the house of a friend to borrow food. Give me 3 loaves, for a friend has come. And this friend refuses because it's time to sleep. He's going to bed. But this friend persists. So, the word there is persisted. Jesus says, in verse 8, I say to you, though he will not rise and give to him, because he is his friend, yet because of his persistence, he will rise and give him as many as he needs. Persistence. Persistence is part and parcel of breakthrough. Persistence. Kwa Kiswahili persistence tunaita ni fuliza. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Because of his persistence, this man will rise from the dead and give him the food he needs. That is what Jesus tells his disciples. Why is Jesus saying this to his disciples? He's encouraging his disciples to pray persistently. Now, to pray persistently, inamaanisha kwamba, you have to pray today, tomorrow, and even the next day until what you are asking for is done. Bwana asifiwe. I want you to understand. I said here one time kwamba Yesu alisema katika maandiko, katika Biblia alisema kwamba if you ask for anything, believe that you got it and it will be yours. Hiyo ni maandiko. Jesus said that, alright? Are we together? Then nikauliza hapa, have you been praying for something? Then we all said yes, we have been praying for some things. And I asked another question, have you received? Then hapo tuliangaliana, eh? Because many of our prayers have not been answered. Is it true? Many of our prayers have not been answered. So we remain wondering, Lord, what really went wrong? What happened? What happened? Does it mean we prayed against the will of God? Some of you may tell me, no, I prayed according to the script. So it means we prayed according to the will of God. But why has it not been answered? If we prayed according to the will of God, why has God not answered? That is where the problem lies. Because we pray, na nilisikia watu wengine akisema, ukiona Mungu akupatii kile ambacho unaomba, then it is not the will of God to give you. So we go asking, Lord, if it is your will, I prayed that way for many years myself. I prayed that way. If it is your will, God, give me. But anything God has promised in the Bible, then he's willing to give you. He's willing to give us because he has promised. So if he has promised wealth in our bosoms,
then he's willing to give us the wealth. But why don't we receive? You know, Samuel akaambia wana wa Israeli, I'm the Lord that gives you power to create wealth. I am the Lord who gives you power to create wealth. No, he does not give you the wealth according to that scripture. He gives you power to create wealth. So how does he give power to create wealth? He gives to you a creative idea. A creative idea. He brings a creative idea to your mind. And then that creative idea helps you or makes you make money.
Bwana asifiwe.
Kwa mfano, he gives you a creative idea, nitengeneze vikapu kutoka kwa waste paper.
Then I'll be selling. So you collect waste paper and then you dye the paper and then you make baskets out of it. Wakati waliband the jewelers, remember? It's a man who got a creative idea. Ule sehemu za Bungoma. Kapata creative idea. And that creative idea, kamwambia, anunue magunia ya sukari. Na cut it to pieces. Alafu aunganishe small bags. Za watu kununua kienda wapi? Kwa supermarket. And that's what he did. Gunia moja ni pesa ngapi? Ile ya sukari. Unajua? I bought one at 20 bob. Ya 50 kilos. So nikati hiyo alafu nikati to the panel na unganisha na kuwa bag ya kwenda kuweka bidhaa kwa supermarket. Na bag moja nauza 50 shillings. Gunia nilinunua 20 bob. Out of that gunia naweza pata how many? About 4 or 5, eh? Nipate from the yako kagunia kamoja. Nipate about 4 or 5. So, if I got 4, how much do I have from one sack? 200. Is it true? 200. Toa kwa gunia moja, but no 24. Unafikiri hiyo haita ni encourage kununua gunia nyingi. Na nitengeneze bags nyingi. Akatengeneza so many bags. Before people knew it, he had made a lot of money. He got a creative idea. And out of that creative idea, he made a lot of money. It is I, the Lord, who gives you power to make wealth or to create wealth. He gives you power to create wealth. So he puts a creative idea in your mind. And that creative idea helps you make a lot of money. That's how he gives you wealth. Bwana asifiwe. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So it is his promise. He says to the children of Israel, it is I, the Lord, who gives you power to make wealth. Now, that's a promise he gives. So why shouldn't I claim for that promise? And if I claim that promise today and I don't receive it, what should I do? Should I just sit there and say, it is not God's will for me to receive? That's where we fail.
Bwana asifiwe.
That's where we do what?
We fail.
We don't pray through. We don't persist in prayer until God does it. We don't. We give up very fast. When you are just on the verge of receiving what God said, you give up. Imagine this man, kama angeenda, alipoenda kwa rafiki yake, akaomba nisaidie nikate. Mgeni amekuja. And then Rafika said, I'm in bed sleeping with my children. The door is shut. Ni usiku sasa. Go home. Alafu atana fanya nini? Aende. Angepata hiyo mikate. But because he persisted, he got what he asked. And even more than what he had asked for. And that's what God wants us. Persisted. That's what God wants us to do.
Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
And therefore, Jesus anasema hivi. Jesus says, ask it to be given unto you, seek it, you'll find, knock, and the door will be opened. For whoever asks is given, whoever knocks, the door is open, whoever seeks, finds. And then anasema, nyinyi ni waovu sana, mnajua peana vipawa vilivyo vizuri kwa watoto wenu.
si zaidi sana Mungu wenu wa mbinguni. Then in Matthew anasema God will surely reward those who pray day and night. Those who pray day and night, He will surely bless them. He will surely give them the Holy Spirit. Those who pray day and night. So, these people pray day and night. Are they just praying once? This man is praying day and night, seeking God, asking God, God, I need this, I need this, I need this, I need this. So what am I saying? If we pray for something, if you pray for something and you don't receive it the first time you pray, what should you do? When the Lord is you. You persist. You pray repeatedly. Repeatedly over that issue. You pray repeatedly until it is done. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
So, what am I trying to tell you again? I'm trying to tell you this. Before you start praying over an issue, think twice. Sit down and think about what you want to pray about. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Do you ever sit down and think about what you want to pray? Yeah? Naposema tu, let us pray. Wewe unasimama tu naanza maneno Lord, mambo unaokota tu kwa nyasi, kwa kichaka hapa, kwa hewa, naokota tu unasema. You must sit down and calculate. You want to go and talk to the president of Kenya. Will you just come from the bush and start talking to the president? You must plan yourself. What am I going to tell the president? This is not a person just simple the way you think. No, the president is the highest person in the land. And when you go to him, you must be organized. What are you going to tell the president? Now, if we can organize ourselves, mpaka unaandika chini what you are going to tell the president. What about God? Bwana asifiwe. Well, God understands. Sawa. God understands. And that's why maandiko inasema unapopiga kelele tu usifikirie Mungu anakusikiliza. So unajua wakati mwingine tunapiga tu kelele kwa maombi yetu tunapiga tu unakosa hivi unatoka unakosa hivi unatoka unakosa hivi. Have you ever made a decision? This time nataka kufuata Mungu mpaka alipe hiki. Or this year I'm going to give it this. And this one I'm going to follow. He has to give me. Alafu umefuata hiyo kutoka January. Unaomba to every day, 31 days in January. God give me a microphone. 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 Bwana unajua ukisitiza namna hiyo the tears of God atasema ai. Microphone. kama vile gari moshi inalia kwa kichwa cha mama John. Kilikilia inalia. Microphone. Sasa inaanza, hiyo microphone inaanza tu kulia kwa kichwa cha Mungu. Microphone. Bagash, let me give this person a microphone. Initoke kwa kichwa. You see? Now, God is not like our fathers. He's not like our mothers. God is not like fellow human beings. He's God. The Supreme. He loves when we go to Him. Now let me tell you. Would you like to hear this? God loves that boldness. That boldness. Hiyo boldness unaenda tu kwake kila siku unamwambia God, you are my father. You are my king. And I come to you boldly. Coming to my father. Knowing that my father hears me very well. Dear Father, I'm asking you to give me the specs. I need the specs. Give them to me, Lord. Kesho tena umetokea, Lord.
You are my father. You are my king. You own everything. Everything on earth belongs to you. Lord of all these things on earth. I'm asking on respect. Give me respect. That's a book. Rudia, respect. Specs inaanza Mungu akiona ndio naona specs. Akiona umekuja naona specs. Mara moja anasema okay my son, here your specs. Na ndio anasema thank you God. That is praying until something happens. Bwana asifiwe. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
How many of us have prayed for the Holy Spirit to fill us to overflow? And we prayed. Mpaka tukasema maybe it's not the will of God to fill me with the Holy Spirit. So let me rest. Let me just go to church. Do you think God does not want to fill us with the Holy Spirit? He wants to fill us to overflow. He wants us to affect the people we come in contact with. He wants us to be flowing of His power. The anointing flowing. He wants that. He wants to see that in His children. But these children of his, walikienda tu siku moja, siku mbili, daddy, fill me the Holy Spirit. Daddy seems to delay, seems to not respond. Daddy, come and fill me the Holy Spirit. He seems to delay, maybe it's not his will. You go to other things. And that's why we don't receive what he has given. What has he given?
Amen.
That's why we don't receive what we ask him. Because tunawacha when we are just about to receive. Unasema it is not his will. You move to another topic. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Bwana apewe sifa.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Are you with me or I've left some of you? Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
How many of you feel ashamed when you are asking God some things? Another lady came to me, I always give these testimonies. Another lady came to me and said, brother, I want a man to marry me. Advise me, how do I go about it? Kamuliza, she was a saved lady. Kamuliza, have you ever asked God that question? How can you ask God such things? How can you ask God about such a thing? Well, dear, my dear, it is God who created these marriages. So he knows all about it. He knows all about it. Have you ever asked him? Now, I have never even thought of asking God such a thing. Come here now, today, may I tell you, go and ask him. So, I know he went before God shamefully. With a lot of shame. God, you are ashamed of what you want to ask. Umewahi kufika hivi kwamba you are ashamed of asking what you want to ask. You are ashamed. May I tell you, my brothers? God wants shameless people to go to him. People are asking things shameless. Did I? You just stand before him and say, God, you said it in your heart. For example, let me give you an example. You said it in your heart. John chapter 14, verse 11, you said in your heart that the works I do, you will do even greater works than this. Will you do? You said it in your heart. Now I want to do the greater works than those you did. Why go kama hii? Unajua, mimi niliambia, kuna mtu aliuliza, when you go before Jesus, what did you tell him? Namwambia Jesus, I served on earth, I preached the gospel more years than you did. Because you were only there, you preached only for 3 years. The one there, Jesus, on the face. You preached for only 3 years. But me, I've been there for over 50 years preaching.
naona ulikuwa ukajua vile kuna taa. Bwana asifiwe. Hiyo itakuwa kosa adabu, sio? Ni kosa adabu. Huyu jamaa hana adabu. No. When you feel free with Jesus, you can tell him everything. You can tell him. Bora umtusi. Bwana asifiwe. When you feel free with Jesus, si anakaa ndani yako. You feel free with him. Just make him a friend. You feel free with him. Unajua friends, si tunaambia friends mambo ya siri sana, hata yale atuambi dada zetu na ndugu zetu. You tell your friends your deeper secrets. Is it true? Kwa nini nyinyi hamna marafiki? Kwa nini mmenyamaza na mnajua tu mmeambia rafiki zenu siri zenu? Bwana asifiwe. You tell your friend your deeper secrets. Hata zile umeficha your brother and your sister, you tell your friend. Now make Jesus your friend. In the Bible, he calls us friends. Anasema, you are my friends. Now, if he calls us friends, we can tell him our deepest secrets. Things that we cannot utter to people. Things we cannot tell people. We tell Jesus. We tell him, Jesus, hapa ndio naugua. Najua kuna magonjwa mengine mnapokuja mbele ya wachungaji wa waombe. Mnakuja na, I'm sick. You don't tell the pastor the real sickness. Wewe ndio unajua. Unajua the real sickness. So mimi mchungaji naomba tu in the name of Jesus I command the disease out. But wewe unajua pale kweli kunaumia. Bwana asifiwe. Maana sehemu zingine ni hazitaki. Eh? So unajua unaumia sehemu hizo. Hazitaki. But you tell mchungaji niombee tu. Afya yangu si mzuri. But when I go to Jesus, I tell him, Lord, even those parts, you know. Lord, you know everything about me. I'm hurting in this area. Please touch me. Jesus wants shameless people to go to him and ask him. People who persist in prayer. People who boldly go before him and ask and claim for the promises that he gave us. Well, as if you, that is, those are the kind of people he wants. Well, as if you, am I talking to people really?
Yes.
Let's go to Matthew. I want you to see this wonderful person here. I want you to see three things from what you are going to read. Matthew 15. Matthew chapter 15, we are starting from verse 21. Verse 21 to 28. Inasema hivi. Then Jesus went out from here and departed to the region of Tyre and Sidon. And behold, a woman of Canaan came from the region and cried out to him, saying, Have mercy on me, O Lord, son of David. My daughter is severely demon-possessed. But he answered her not a word. And his disciples came and urged him, saying, Send her away, for she cries out after us. Verse 24. But he answered and said, I was not sent except to the lost sheep of the house of Israel. Then she came and worshipped him, saying, Lord, help me. But he answered and said, It is not good to take the children's bread and throw it to the little dogs. And she said, Yes, Lord, yet even the little dogs eat the crumbs which fall from their master's table. Jesus answered and said to her, "Oh woman, great is your faith. Let it be to you as you desire." And her daughter was healed from that very hour. I want you to see what Jesus did to this woman. Mbazo, wewe ungefanyiwa, sijui ungesemaje. Ungefanyiwa wewe, ungesema huyo Yesu na akae. Mimi ndiye anaweza kunijibu. Akae. Simtaki. But look at the first instance. The woman asks. The first thing you should notice, this was a woman of Cana. Therefore, huyu hakuwa Mwisraeli. Then she comes to Jesus and anauliza, "Heal my daughter." Then Jesus gives a deaf ear. Namwangalia tu. Kama ni wewe, ungefanyaje? Then she comes a second time and asks. And before she asks, the disciples are asking Jesus to send her away. Talk, muambia aende na kupigia kelele. Then the woman comes and says, "Heal my daughter." Then, yes, anamjibu rudi. Anamjibu rudi. Jibu la Yesu ni kwamba, "I was sent to the lost sheep of the house of Israel." This woman was not an Israelite. She was a Canaanite. So Jesus anamwambia, "I was sent to a particular people, the Israelites, not to you, the Gentiles." Kama ni wewe ungeambiwa hiyo na Mungu mwenyewe, unge give up, si ndio? Nasema, "Ai, Mungu amesema. Mungu amesema I cannot do this to a Gentile." Then the woman never took that as an answer. She never took that as an answer. Then she asked again, "Heal my daughter." Then Jesus says, "It is not good to give children's food to dogs." The word used there is little dogs. So you know little dogs are pets. They are pets, those pets. So now this woman is compared to a little dog, to a pet. Mungu kusema kitu kama hicho. It's not good to give children's food to little dogs. Now this woman is compared with a little dog. Kama ni mimi ningesema, "Okay, now I've been, this is the worst insult." But the woman never gives up. She says to Jesus, "Even the little dogs eat the crumbs from the master's table." Then Yesu anaposikia hiyo, that persistence touches him. Then Jesus says, "Woman, great is your faith. Let it be done to you as you wish." And from that day, her daughter was healed. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
That persistence in that woman gave her what she desired. She did not give up until Jesus gave a positive answer. The first answer was negative. The second answer was negative. The third answer was negative. She never took negative as an answer until Jesus turned and gave her a positive answer. That is praying through. Well, as if you will. That is praying through. And God wants you and I to pray through. Let me tell you one thing. It doesn't mean that you don't have faith when you go back to God every day asking for the same thing. It does not mean that you lack faith. It means you have a lot of faith in God. That's what it means. That's why you're going back to Him, asking Him. Because you have not gone anywhere else to ask. You have gone back to Him. It is because you have a lot of faith in Him. That's why you go back to Him. You are confident that He can do it. And that's why you're going back to Him repeatedly. So God is looking for such people who will not take no as an answer.
But people will persist in prayer and seek his face day and night, year after year, seeking him until he comes down with his glory. One has a few. We want to be filled of the Holy Spirit. We want to move in the power of the Holy Spirit. Have you prayed? How many times did you pray? You feel like you have prayed, you have prayed. Now it seems God is not answering. May I tell you, it is now time to start. When you feel that God is not answering, that is the time you should start and push until God turns and says, here I am, my son. Get what you wanted. Take it. What has it feel? If there are people who are praying against God's will and God gave them, what about you who pray according to God's will? Don't you think we shall receive and more than what we ask? What has it feel? I've given you many, many examples here. So what am I saying? What am I telling you? I'm telling you, God wants persistence in you and consistency. Persistence and consistency in you. Sio unaomba leo, kesho uone. There's no consistency. You are aiming at a particular thing or particular things. Hizo ndio unataka Mungu akupatie this year. Unataka vitu hivi Mungu akupatie this year. These two things God I'm asking this year, grant. Then you persist in prayer and consistently ask. Then he's going to give. Bwana asifiwe. Bwana asifiwe. Hallelujah. Bwana asifiwe. So what am I saying now? I'm saying I want you to sit down and think before you go before God. Just pick out some things you want God to do for you. And you must make sure there are promises God has given in his word that he'll grant to those who seek him. And persist in prayer for those things. You can pick two, you can pick three, you can pick the number you want. But make sure you persistently and consistently pray over that thing until God answers. And you'll bring us testimonies here. You'll bring us testimonies that I picked A, B, C, D to pray God to grant me. And he has granted me. How long did I pray? I prayed for this length of time. I wonder, you know, Wazungu Lishangaza, they keep a record of all the things they do. So they keep a record. The day they begin to pray about something, they keep a record. And they will tell you how long they pray. How long? And God answered. They'll tell you. They keep records. Can we try that, we Africans? One has a view. Is it possible for us to try? Or tutasema sisi wazungu, sisi ni Afrika. Can we try?
Yes.
Can we just try and get some items you want to pray? Put them down. And then start praying. Not the date you start praying. Start praying. Push. And you'll start here and tell us a testimony. I started praying this day, and I pray for this length of time, and God answered. Is it possible?
Yes.
I want us to be people who will harp on God
until he does what you're asking. Provided it is his promise. What he promised in his word. Bwana asifiwe. That's how we receive the promises. Are you going to do that?
Yes.
I'm not asking you to do it now. You know, I want you to go and sit down. See, tonight I'm very appreciative that. Who is our king? Our father. You are going before him, right? You plan yourself. I want you to go and plan yourself. Organize yourself properly. I want to ask God for these three things. He has to grant me. And Lord, I'm not taking no for an answer. Because we have great faith in him. Si una imani sana ndani ya Mungu. Yeah. So now we want to hang on him. It doesn't matter how long you'll pray, but you want to prove God true to his word. True to his word. That's what we want to do. We have to prove God true to his word. And please don't give up. Hata ukiona dalili ya hiyo kitu kufanyika, don't stop praying until it is done. Kifanyika tu pa, nasimama na ushuhuda. Nasema, yes, God granted. When I asked, he gave me. Do you want to prophesy? How many want to prophesy? Take that prophecy as an agenda. Because Paul said, I would want all of you to prophesy. Have you ever read that scripture? I would wish all of you prophesy. So, I want you to take things that you want God to do in your life. You may want to go to heaven, so that will be an agenda. What does it feel? You know, going to heaven means something else. Which may leave some people crying. Bwana asifiwe. So you take an items, write them down. You can write them down, keep them in your Bible. And you always remember to ask God the same things until they are done. When one is done, you tick. When the second one is done, you tick. When the third one is done, you tick. That's how God wants his children to operate, so that he may prove himself right to his word. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
So I've given you an agenda, and I've given you an assignment. We are getting into the new year. We are starting December next week, this week. December in answer this week. Plan yourself. 2018 should never be the same as 2017. 2017, I struggled so much. Shall I continue struggling in 2018? So I'm preparing your mind. As you get into the new year, I'm preparing your mind. We should prove God true to his word by us persisting in prayer. And as you persist in prayer, make sure you make the word of God your living standard. Sio uende ufanye maovu urudi hapa. No. Tugaje na kwambie kwamba hivi. You must live according to the word of God and prove it true to his word. Bwana asifiwe. We want some people in our midst to buy cars next year. This year. Hey, we want to see cars parking here. We want them. These are things God said he'll give us. But why hasn't he given us? We want some of you who think that you are nobodies to become somebodies. By persisting in the prayer. That's what he does. He lifts up those people who are looked down at. While I'm bad at their reviewers, and only kind of like nobodies. But God makes them, turns them into somebodies. We whose years have advanced, and we think it is all lost, though our years be restored.
Amen.
ile miaka imeliwa na nzige na madumadu. Your years that were eaten by caterpillars, cankerworms, palmerworm, and what? And locusts. Be restored.
Amen.
That's what we want now. And that it will be a claim. See, I mean, in his word, that your years that were eaten by cankerworms, palmerworms, caterpillars, and locusts will be restored. And the same in this one, if someone dies at 100 years, he has died a young person. So I want to claim 100 years.
Amen.
I want to live a whole century. Amen. If possible, 2 centuries.
Amen.
When does he do it?
Amen.
And I should remain strong. Amen. To serve him. Amen. All those years.
Amen.
If I claim this, shall I be claiming out of the scriptures? One as you.
Amen.
If there's any desire I have in my heart, I tell you, if there's any desire I have in my heart, is to serve him until he comes.
Amen.
That is the desire I have.
Amen.
And I tell you, in my prayer, I ask every day, Lord, I want to serve you. I want to remain true to your word. That's why at our cutting a pig, I'm taking a beast. Nasikia uchungu lakini naangalia nasema no, I'm not falling down. Nasikia tu uchungu kieni. No, I'm not falling down. Never, I'm not falling down. Unajua sometimes unapigwa nini amjui. I was telling some people yesterday, there's something I declared in the church. And I've been beaten thoroughly. Beaten, seriously. Why did you do this? Because the declaration I made, ilikuwa ya kumshinda kabisa, kumwangamiza shetani. So, mimi nimekuwa kupigwa kwanza. Pigwa kweli kweli. Pigwa juu chini. Nema top bottom center, sideways. Pigwa. But I'm telling no. I'm not falling. Una pigwa mpaka unasikia uanguke chini, lakini unasema no, not falling. Then God comes and starts with you. One as if you will.
Amen.
So we want things, eh? We want things. Apart from the spiritual things, we also want material things. Because these material things support the spiritual things. One as if you will. If I'm so spiritual and I don't have food to put on the table, ingia kwa nyumba watoto wananjaa na niangalia tu wameisha. You know, even if they are not talking, you feel it. So your spirituality na manyari? Inarudi chini. Wewe kama mzee umeingia kwa nyumba, mke wako ameshinda njaa, kimwangalia ameisha. Hata kama aongei, unajua, unasikia tu ndani ya mifupa, ndani ya roho yako, kweli iko shida. So God should give us even material things, which will support the spiritual. Ukitoka kwa nyumba, umejaza watu chakula, umejaza pocket money, you know. Ukienda hata kuhubiri watu, unahubiri kabisa ukiwa huko nyuma. Watu wako mzuri. Bwana asifiwe. Lakini unahubiri na huko nyuma analia njaa. Hata kwa pulpit unahubiri lakini unasikia tu. Ina visit the mind. Niliwaacha njaa. Nashtuka kidogo, hata anointing pia inashtuka. But when I've left them full with food, wako salama, najua hata wale huko nao pia wamepiga goti wanaomba, Lord, use your servant where he is. Now they are calling me a what?
Servant.
Use your servant where he is. Fill him with your power. So ninapohubiri na wao wanaomba huko nyuma, what do you think happens? Miracles happen. People are healed. Yeah? Things happen. So this material thing supports the spiritual things. When I see
you.
We need them, right? Do we need them?
Yes.
All right. Unajua kuna maandiko kwa Biblia ambayo
watu wanaposoma wanakosa kuelewa, alafu wanaomba hivi, all right? Lemuel, anaitwa Lemuel, aliomba Mungu, usinipe sana nisije nikatajirika sana nikakusahau. Hivi ndio wengine watu naomba, sio? Well, if you know you are weak with the money, pray that. Because ukiomba, mimi naomba Mungu nipe mingi, imwagike ili nisaidie wanaohitaji msaada wangu.
Amen.
Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Because sasa nikipewa tu enough, it will be enough for me and my. Yes, it's enough. So, Joseph akija, Merala aja, shall I help him? I just have enough. But when I have much, I can give it. Tunaingia tu kwa bank. Naambia Joseph, kuja, kuja. Hebu tuingia. Alafu ATM, kwa machine. Pesa zimetoka 10,000. Shika. Hata nunua chakula. Because I have much. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
So should not rest on enough. Lemuel akasema, God, just give me enough. All right. If you know you are weak, you cannot handle material things, please ask for enough. Don't ask for much. But if you know your heart yearns to touch people, to touch other people, don't ask for enough. Ask for plenty. Ask for plenty. Lord, I need you to give me plenty, plenty. Let it be overflowing in my house. So that again working here, they don't go out hungry. They have something to eat. But when I have enough, hata ukinitembelea, I have enough. I'm going to pick a chai na fikiria mara mbili, itapunguza budget. Unafikiria mara mbili. Unajua siku hizi tunaenda na budget. So, you know. Bwana asifiwe. We want plenty. I personally want plenty. What else? I want plenty of his anointing in my life. Plenty. Plenty. Not just enough in our take for the church. Plenty of it. So that it flows. My cup runs over. My cup overflows. So when my cup overflows, when it's overflowing and you step in the overflow, what will happen to you? Unakutana na kila ambacho hukutarajia, sio? That's when you find people are being arrested out of the church. Watu wanashikwa tu na Roho Mtakatifu na wanasa huko nje. Na wanaleta ndani. Na wanasa, mnaitwa huko nje. Kujeni hapa, watu wameamka hapa, nyinyi tu mnawezana nao. Because the anointing is overflowing. One has a view. Do we need these things?
Yes.
We have to push. We have to pray through. Make it your agenda. Eh? Ask it, Lord. Even if it means fasting and praying. Asking God, I need this anointing. I need this anointing. Ask it. Ask it. Until he grants it. You are not taking no for an answer. But you want yes. Here you are. Take it. Want to have a lot of anointing in that we can also supply. Isn't it?
Yes.
One has a few.
Amen.
You know you can have a lot of anointing that you can also supply. Want to akija unawekea mkono na aina na prophesy hiyo na prophesy. Have you ever known that?
Yes.
You know, impartation. Yeah? Well, namwekea mikono naenda nafanya miujiza, vile unafanya miujiza. Hiyo inamaanisha anointing imeshuka mpaka imejaa, ina overflow sasa. Eh, nikikuwekea mkono na kuita tu fla. Wewe kuja hapa, John kuja hapa. Alafu John anakuja namwekea mkono namwambia ombea huyo mtu, anaomba huyo mtu anapona. You think that can happen? Yeah. So now I'm showing you another way. Watu hawa mnaona wakifanya miujiza, that's how they pray. They never took no for an answer. Na mtu anafunga mpaka na kurudi anakuwa kijiti, macho inaingia ndani ya sockets. Nyama za zinaingia ndani ya mifupa. Na ukimwangalia anakaa skeleton. The bones are showing. Huyu mtu amekuwa akitafuta Mungu kwa udi na uvumba. Akisimama unaona upepo utaangusha. Hamwai kufunga mpaka upepo ukivuma unaenda na upepo. I tell you, it does happen. And when God answers, unaona sasa wameweka nyama kwa mwili ile inakuja yote. Na miujiza inafanyika, napumua tu na mimi mambo inafanyika. Kipumua tu mambo inafanyika, kinua tu mkono mambo inafanyika. Because God has answered. So situkubali kukonda kwa sasa, and then later on nyama irudi kwa mwili. Mekubali?
Yes.
Tupoteze nyama kwa muda, sio? Kitafuta uso wa Mungu. Alafu baadaye nyama itarudi, sio? You know, anointing ikishuka. Anointing ikishuka, nyama inarudi. You know that?
Yes.
Bwana asifiwe. I look at this man from Nigeria, anaitwa TB Joshua. Alikuwa anafunga 40 days kwa mlima peke yake. 40 days. Na unajua wakati huo alikuwa anafunga alikuwa
1 GB.
Alikuwa 1 GB. Sometimes ninaona picha zake wakati alikuwa anafunga alikuwa mwembamba. Hata mimi nafikiri alikuwa na vasa size 26. Alikuwa mwembamba kweli kweli. Na mifupa ungeangalia na kadevu kamenishindwa hata kunyoa ndevu. But when the anointing came, right now, ana mwili kibonge cha mtu. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Because he got what he was looking for. He got what he was asking. Now he's just moving in it. He's just enjoying it. He is enjoying it. Hata wakati wengine tunaangalia kiwekelea tu mikono na shina na uja macho. Maelfu ya watu unawekelea mikono. Eh? Acho. But you find that he's just enjoying it. He's enjoying it. Maybe anasikia uchovu akishamaliza. Yanakienda kaa chini anasikia uma. Kumbe nilikuwa nalima shamba. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Do you want that to happen to you?
Yes.
Eh?
Yes.
Kama unataka utakubali. Upoteze mwili kidogo.
Hmm?
Utakubali. Utakubali upoteze mwili kiasi. And then things will happen. And then now this happens to people who have a focus. You are focusing on this issue and I want this done in my life. God, this is what I want done. Then you focus on that. And for sure I tell you, some of you will give testimonies next year.
Amen.
You will give testimonies what God has done.
Amen.
What has it been?
Amen.
I'm finished. I feel I'm finished. May we rise up. Just go home, make up your mind. Decide, I want, this is what I want God to do for me. Write them down. And never quit praying over those things you have outlined until the answers come. And I can hear very well that some of you will give testimonies.
Amen.
What does it feel?
Amen.
Give testimonies of what God will have done. God loves these bold people who go to Him shamelessly, bold, persistent, and consistent asking. You will not ask for fish and it gives you a scorpion. You will not ask for bread and it gives you a stone. He He's a father who loves us and he cares for us. So if he asks for fish, he'll give you fish. If he asks for bread, he'll give you bread. God is looking for such people who ask him day and night so that he may grant them.
Binadamu yake Yesu, sina wema wa kutosha, dhambi zangu kuziosha.
Let us ask for the spirit of prayer, Lord, to give us the spirit of prayer. Father, we ask you in the name of Jesus. Father, I pray in the name of Jesus Christ, let your power flow in our lives, Lord. Let your spirit of prayer fill our lives today, forever, Lord Jesus. That we shall consistently come before the Lord, Lord
Jesus, we love Jesus. Only calling upon the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Let your name be glorified. We give you praise and glory, Lord Jesus. Heal us today, Lord. Fill us with your power. Fill us with the spirit of prayer. That's what God has done. Lord Jesus, I pray. That we shall seek your face. That every day we shall walk in your divine presence. Lord, we shall have glory of your name. We love you, Lord Jesus. We give you praise, Lord. We adore you, my God, of Israel. Thank you for your presence. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. But we pray this afternoon that you will grant us with your spirit, the spirit of prayer, the spirit of intercession, that we shall stand before you in intercession, Lord Jesus. We are asking, Father, that each one of us will stand before you, and we need that boldness, that desire to pray, that desire to seek the face of God, that desire, that lakomosina, that determination, Lord Jesus Christ. We are asking for that determination to pray, determination to seek the face of God. Lord, I pray each one of us standing here today, you shall grant us this determination. You shall grant us this persistence and this consistency, Lord Jesus, that in everything we do, Lord, everywhere we go, we shall have this determination. We shall have this persistence. We shall have this consistency, Lord, that every time we pray, Lord Jesus, we shall come boldly before the throne of grace and receive that grace that will help us in time of need. We give you praise and glory. Thank you, Father, for your people who are standing here. The sick in our midst, we pray that they be healed in the name of Jesus. Father, we pray that those who have different needs, their needs be met in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Lord, we shall honor you and glorify you now and forever, because you are our King. In Jesus' name, we pray. Amen.